Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for waking me up this morning. Thank you for my health. Thank you for all my loved ones. Thank you for this quiet time I'm taking out in this day to spend with you, Lord, to bask in your presence. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name, Lord. I give it all up to you, Lord. Every problem, every challenge, every trauma. And there is no fear, for you did not create a spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. I arise today through God's strength to pilot me, God's might to uphold me, God's wisdom to guide me, God's eye to look before me, God's ear to hear me, God's word to speak for me, God's hand to guard me, God's way to lie before me, God's shield to protect me, God's host to save me from snares of devils, from temptations of vices, from everyone who shall wish me ill, afar and near, alone and in multitude. I summon all these powers between me and those evils, against every cruel, merciless power that may oppose my body and soul, against incantations of false prophets, against black laws of pagandom, against false laws of heretics, against craft of idolatry, against spells of witches and smiths and wizards, against every knowledge that corrupts man's body and soul. Christ, to shield me today against poison, against burning, against drowning, against wounding, so that there may come to me an abundance of reward. Christ with me, Christ before me, Christ behind me, Christ in me, Christ beneath me, Christ above me, Christ on my right, Christ on my left, Christ when I lie down, Christ when I sit down, Christ when I arise, Christ in the heart of every man who thinks of me, Christ in the mouth of everyone who speaks of me, Christ in every eye that sees me, Christ in every ear that hears me. I arise today through a mighty strength of the invocation of the Trinity, through belief in the threeness, through confession of the oneness of the Creator of creation. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name, O Lord. Praise your name. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be exceedingly glad in it. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. Call upon me, and I will answer you, and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, you are my refuge and my fortress, my God, in you I will trust. Surely you will deliver me from the snare of the fowler, and from the perilous pestilence you will cover with your feathers, and under your wings I shall take refuge. Your truth shall be my shield and buckler. I shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the destruction that lays waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at my side, 10,000 at my right hand, but it shall not come near me. Only with my eyes shall I look and see the reward of the wicked. Because I have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, my dwelling place. No evil shall befall me, nor shall any plague come near my dwelling. For you shall give your angels charge over me to keep me in all my ways. In their hands they shall bear me up. I will trust in you, Lord, with all my heart, and lean not to my own understanding. In all my ways I acknowledge you, Lord, and know that you will direct my path. For you, O Lord, shall supply all my need according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. For I look not at the things that are seen, but at the things that are not seen. For the things that are seen are temporal, while things that are not seen are eternal. By your stripes I am healed, for I walk by faith, not by sight. For without faith, it is impossible to please you. And those who come to you must believe that you are, and that you are a rewarder to those who diligently seek you. I cast all my care on you, Lord, for you care for me. I can do all things through Christ, who strengthens me. Behold, you have given me authority to trample over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt me. And you, O Lord, will deliver me from every evil work and preserve me for your heavenly kingdom. Delight in you, O Lord, and you will give me the desires of my heart. Wait on you and keep your words, and you will abide with me. Wait on you and keep your words, and you will exalt me to inherit the land. If I abide in you and your words abide in me, then I shall ask what I desire, and it shall be done for me. Whatever things I desire, when I pray, I must believe that I receive them, and I shall have them. Now this is the confidence that I have in you, O Lord, that if I ask anything according to your will, you hear me. And if I know that you hear me, whatever I ask, I know I have the petitions I have asked of you. I rejoice always, pray without ceasing, in everything give thanks, for this is your will for me. I know that you will never leave me nor forsake me, and that you will be with me even to the end of the age. And these signs shall follow those who believe. In my name they shall cast out demons. They shall speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents, and if they drink anything deadly, it will by no means hurt them. They will lay hands upon the sick, and they will recover. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your word, Lord. Thank you for your blessings, Lord. Thank you for the victory in everything that I'm facing right now, Lord. I praise your name, Lord. I praise your name, Lord, continuously. I praise you, praise you, praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Jesus, I lift up every person in my family, in my prayer circle, friends, everyone on my prayer list, the prayer request list, and anyone and everyone who needs prayer this day, named or unnamed, and whatever it is you know they may be needing this day. And may their life be full of your peace, prosperity, and power as they seek to have a closer relationship with you. For you are Yahweh, the Lord, El Elyon, the Most High, El Shaddai, the Almighty, Elohim, the Sublime God, Adonai, my Lord and Master, Jehovah Jireh, my Provider, Jehovah Rapha, my Healer, Jehovah Imkedesh, my Sanctifier, Jehovah Nisi, my Victory, my Banner, Jehovah Shalom, my Peace, Jehovah Tisitkenu, my Righteousness, Jehovah Rohai, my Shepherd, and Jehovah Shammah, my Helper. As you said in your word, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And my God shall supply all my need according to his riches and glory through Christ Jesus. And all things are possible to him that believeth. In believing in your word, Lord, I commit to trust in you with all my heart, and lean not to my own understanding. In all my ways I acknowledge you, Lord, and you will direct my path. I thank you, Lord, for all the many blessings in my life, and I thank you in advance for all the blessings I am about to receive for being obedient to your word. I thank you for blessing me, my family, my loved ones, and everyone else who needs prayer this day, named or unnamed, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Father, in Jesus' name, bless me and my family and all those who are close to me, as well as all those on my prayer list, in a special way. Open supernatural doors in their life today. Save and set free. Give them a double portion of your spirit as we take back everything the devil has stolen. Emotional health, physical health, finances, relationships, children, jobs, homes, marriages. I cancel every plot, plan, and scheme the enemy has devised against them in the matchless name of Jesus. And I declare that no weapon formed against them will prosper. I speak life into every dead situation. And I thank you that nothing is over until you say it's over. I speak prophetically into all of their lives today and all of their situations. Households are blessed. Health is blessed. Marriages are blessed. Finances are blessed. Jobs are blessed. Children are blessed. Grandchildren are blessed. Our parents are blessed. Siblings are blessed. Ministries are blessed. And our decisions are blessed. Husbands are on the way. Wives are on the way. Mortgages are paid and canceled. And our heart's desires are on the way according to your perfect will and plan for our lives. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise your name, O Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you. I just want to bask in your presence, Lord. I feel you all around me right now. I feel your presence. No matter how bad things may seem, Lord, I know you are right here with me every step of the way. Whether I think I see you or not, Lord, I know you're right here with me. Thank you. Praise you, Lord. Praise your mighty name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. In the name of Jesus, I bind the wills of every person, known and unknown, in my family, siblings, parents, friends, prayer list, prayer warriors, anyone else not named, to the will and mind of Christ. I bind our body, soul, and spirit to the mind, emotions, purposes, and will of God for our lives. I bind our mind, will, and emotions to the will of God. I bind us to the truth and the blood of Jesus. I bind our minds to the mind of Christ, that the very thoughts, feelings, and purposes of his heart would be within our thoughts. I bind our feet to the paths of righteousness, that their steps would be steady and sure. I bind each of us to God's timing in our lives. I bind us to the work of the cross, with all its mercy, grace, love, forgiveness, and dying to self. I loose every old, wrong, ungodly pattern of thinking, attitude, desire, idea, belief, motivation, habit, and behavior from us. I tear down, crush, smash, and destroy every stronghold associated with these things. I loose any stronghold in our lives that has been justifying and protecting hard feelings against anyone. I loose the strongholds of unforgiveness, fear, and distrust from us. I loose the power and effects of deceptions and lies from us. I loose confusion and blindness of the God of this world from our mind that has kept us from seeing the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I call forth every precious word of scripture that has ever entered into our mind and heart, that it would rise up in power within us. In the name of Jesus, I loose the power and effects of any harsh or hard words, word curses spoken to, about, or by us. I loose all generational bondages and associated strongholds from us. I loose all effects and bondages and associated strongholds from us that may have been caused by mistakes we have made. Father, in the name of Jesus, I crush, smash, and destroy generational bondages of any kind from mistakes made at any point between generations. I destroy them right here, right now. They will not bind and curse any more members of these families. I bind the strong man Satan that we may spoil his house, taking back sevenfold every material and spiritual possession he has wrongfully taken from us. I loose the enemy's influence over every part of our body, soul, and spirit. I loose, crush, smash, and destroy every evil device he may try to bring into our sphere of influence during this day. I loose all negative influences of the world from us. I crush, smash all the deceptions the enemy may try to use to confuse us. I tear apart, wreck, crack, crush, and rip asunder the effects of the enemy in every area of our lives. Finances, families, homes, work, and businesses. I bind and loose these people in Jesus' name. God has given me the keys and the authority to do so, and I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise your name, Lord. Praise your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name, Lord. Thank you. Praise your name, Father. Praise your name. Hallelujah. I thank you for my being able to see and to hear this morning. I am blessed because you are a forgiving God and an understanding God. You have done so much for me, and you keep on blessing me. Forgive me this day, for I have sinned. I ask now for forgiveness. Keep me safe from all danger and harm. Let me start this day with a new attitude and plenty of gratitude. Let me make the best of each and every day and give my best in all that is put before me. Clear my mind that I can hear from you. Broaden my mind that I can accept all things. Let me continue to see sin through your eyes and acknowledge it as evil. And when I sin, let me repent and confess with my mouth my wrongdoing and receive the forgiveness of God. And when this world closes in on me, let me remember to slip away and find a quiet place to pray. It is the best response when I am pushed beyond my limits. I know that when I pray, you listen to my heart. Continue to use me to do thy will. Continue to bless me, that I may be a blessing to others. Keep me strong, that I may help the weak. Keep me uplifted, that I may have words of encouragement for others. I pray for those that are lost and can't find their way. I pray for those that are misjudged and misunderstood. I pray for those who refuse to share a word from you. I pray for those who don't know you intimately. I pray for those who will not share the word with others. I pray for those that don't believe. But I thank you that I believe that you change people and you change things. I pray for all my sisters and brothers, for each and every family member in their households. I pray for peace, love, and joy in their homes, and that they are out of debt and all their needs are met. Hallelujah. I pray that these words be received into the hearts of every person who hears this and confesses them willingly. This is my prayer. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name, Lord. Praise your wonderful name, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Ah, yes, Lord. I say yes, Lord. Glory to your name, Lord. Praise your wonderful name, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Ah, yes, Lord. Praise your name. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. I say yes, Lord, to your will. Yes, Lord, to your way. Hallelujah. I send for the holy angels of God right now. They are commissioned to minister on behalf of the heirs of salvation. I am an heir of salvation. I am washed in the blood of Christ. I am blood bought, Holy Ghost filled, and fire baptized. I'm not waiting to get into the kingdom of God. I am in the kingdom now, and the kingdom is in me. The King has come to live in me. I have stepped out of darkness into light. I've been translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light. The love of God has been shed abroad in my heart by Christ Jesus. I have the covenant right that empowers me to stand firm and to prophesy. I have the covenant right to declare the holy angels of God to go forth in the fields and bring in my harvest. In the name and authority of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, Lord. In the name of Jesus, I am more than a conqueror, even in darkness. Right now, I prepare my way with the anointed word of God. I have been honored with the right to execute judgment written in Jesus' name. And when I speak God's word, even in the midst of darkness, I shall have light. Victory all the time. That's mine, in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, this is the victory that overcomes the world, even my faith. I overcome the world with victory Jesus has obtained. I maintain victory Jesus has obtained. In the name of Jesus, I declare that right now, my God always causes me to have the decisive, settled victory in everything through the anointing. I always have victory over my enemies because God shows favor to me. In the name of Jesus, I will change my focus from the world to the Word and expect a miracle. I expect a miracle every day. God always causes me to have victory every day. Miracles are available every day. Therefore, I expect a miracle every day. In the name of Jesus, I am an overcomer. I have been born of God. This is the victory that overcomes the world, even my faith. In the name of Jesus, my part of the fellowship of His love is the key to victory that Jesus obtained. In the name of Jesus, offenses will never hurt me. I declare that I am not self-assured. I am God-assured. In the name of Jesus, my victory comes by refusing to judge by what my eyes see and what my ears hear. But my victory comes by trusting what God has promised me. In the name of Jesus, I declare I have victory all the time. In the name of Jesus, I am a son of God, and I declare now the battle will soon become a meal. It will become an experience that will nourish and build me up spiritually. In the name of Jesus, I declare breakthrough, come forth. I command you, let the redeemed of the Lord come forth, in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I will maintain that victory. Thank you, Father. I am triumphant over the enemy. I am an overcomer. I am a victor in the anointed Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I don't have because I don't expect. But now, I expect. Not every now and then, but every day. Every day, I expect a miracle. Every day, I expect a favor from God. Every day, I expect triumph, victory, and success. It's been made available. I have an expected end, and it shall not be cut off. In the name of Jesus, miracles are available. Increase is available. Healing is available. And joy is available. In the name of Jesus, I expect what has been made available to me by the anointed Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I declare I have victory. All the time. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise your name, O Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory to your name, Lord. Glory to your name. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise your name, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I am strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. I put on the whole armor of God that I may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Therefore, I take the whole armor of God, that I may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand, therefore, having girded my waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, having shod my feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace, above all, taking the shield of faith, with which I shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end, with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. O Lord, you have made a hedge around me, around my household, and around all that I have on every side. The angel of the Lord encamps around all those who fear him and delivers them. The Lord shall be a wall of fire around me. Do not be afraid, says the Lord. I am your shield. You, O Lord, are a shield for me, my glory, and the one who lifts up my head. No weapon formed against me shall prosper, and every tongue which rises against me in judgment, I shall condemn. I will not be afraid of sudden terror, nor of trouble when it comes, for the Lord will be my confidence and will keep my foot from being caught. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers me out of them all. Call upon you, O Lord, in the day of trouble, and you will deliver me, and I shall glorify you. Cast my burden on you, Lord, and you will sustain me. You shall never permit the righteous to be moved. And you, O Lord, will deliver me from every evil work and preserve me for your heavenly kingdom. Do not fear, for those who are with us are more than those who are with them. Greater is he that is in me than he who is in the world. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Whatever you bound on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Therefore, Satan, in the name of Jesus, I bind you and all demonic forces right now. I bind all the spirits of retribution, revenge, and retaliation who may try to attack the person listening to this message right now. And I loose you, demonic forces, from your assignment against me, those listening to this message, our finances, our careers, our family, and all those who are close to us. In the mighty name of Jesus, I put a hedge of protection around everyone just named and those unnamed who are listening to this message, and command the angels to encamp around all of us and all of our affairs every hour of the day and night. For behold, you have given us the authority to trample over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt us. The Lord blesses me and keeps me. The Lord makes his face to shine upon me and be gracious to me. The Lord lifts up his countenance upon me and gives me peace. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise your mighty name. Praise your name. Oh, you said in your word, Lord, Psalms 103. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives all your iniquities? Who heals all your diseases? Who redeems your life from destruction? Who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies? Who satisfies your mouth with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles? The Lord executes righteousness and justice for all who are oppressed. He made known his ways to Moses, his acts to the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in mercy. He will not always strive with us, nor will he keep his anger forever. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor punished us according to our iniquities. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so great is his mercy toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far he removed our transgressions from us. As a father pities his children, so the Lord pities those who fear him. For he knows our frame. He remembers that we are dust. For as man, his days are like grass, a flower of the field, and so he flourishes. For the wind passes over it, and it is gone. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting on those who fear him, and his righteousness to his children's children, to such as keep his covenant, to those who remember his commandments to do them. The Lord has established his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, you his angels, who excel in strength, who do his word, heeding to the voice of his word. Bless the Lord, all you his hosts, you ministers of his, who do his pleasure. Bless the Lord, all his works, in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Jesus, it is your will for me to walk in healing, for me to walk in divine health. I know the truth. I have heard the word. Faith has come. I have faith in healing. I know some things now. Now, in the name of Jesus, I release my faith now, and I declare right now, I will not turn loose what's mine. Healing is mine. I am an heir of healing. I have a right to it. Jesus has given it to me, and in the name of Jesus, I will not give away what he has given to me. And now I declare boldly before all of heaven that I do not plan for one moment to give up, to cave in, and to quit. But I do plan to receive everything that has been promised in the Word of God. And I declare healing in my life, healing in my body, healing in my mind. I boldly say, I am healed, I am healed, I am healed right now in the name of Jesus. The gospel that I have heard is the power of God into salvation. I confess Jesus Christ as Lord over my life, spirit, soul, and body. I receive the power of God to make me sound, whole, delivered, saved, and healed right now. I act on the Word of God and I receive the power of God. Sickness, disease, pain, I resist you in the name of Jesus. You are not the will of God. I enforce the Word of God on you. I will not tolerate you in my life. Leave my presence. I will never allow you back. My days of sickness and disease are over. I am healed. 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 I am the healed, protecting my health. I am saved. The power of sickness and disease has been broken forever over my life. Jesus bore my sickness, my weakness, and my pain. I am forever free. Sickness shall no longer lord over me. Sin shall no longer lord it over me. Fear shall no longer lord it over me. Satan shall no longer lord it over me. I have a covenant of peace, and it shall not be removed. I have been redeemed from the curse of the law. I proclaim my freedom in Jesus' name. Today, the gospel is the power of God to me. Under salvation, I receive the gospel. I act on the gospel. I am made whole in Jesus' name. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. I am the redeemed of the Lord. I have said it, and it is so in Jesus' name. God is healing me right now. Every ache and pain in my body is healed right now in Jesus' name. The blood of Jesus is covering me from head to toe. Every cell in my body is being healed right now by the blood of Jesus in the name of Jesus. Stress is leaving my body. Aches and pains are leaving my body in Jesus' name. Healing is taking place in areas that I don't even know had any dis-ease within them. Healing is taking place right now in Jesus' name. Lord, I thank you for my healing. Thank you for healing my body, my finances, my life, my relationships, my family. Thank you, Lord, for healing everything in my life right now. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise your name, Father. Praise your name, Father. Glory to your name. Hallelujah. Now, Lord, I lift up every debt, financial obligation, loan, any financial situation, I lift them all up to you right now, Lord, so that the devil cannot use them against me to steal my joy and my praise. As you say in Romans 10:17, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, and what brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. Psalms 1:1-3. 3 John 1:2 says, Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in health, just as your soul prospers. Malachi 3:10, Bring all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house, and try me now, says the Lord, if I will not open for you the windows of heaven and pour out for you such blessings that there will not be enough room to receive it. Luke 6:38, Give, and it will be given to you. Pressed down, shaken together, and running over will be put into your bosom. For with the same measure that you use, it will be measured back to you. Second Corinthians 9:6-9, But this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. He who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Let each one give as he purposes in his heart, not grudgingly, nor of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you, having all sufficiency in all things, may have an abundance for every good work. I no longer operate by the world system of debt cancellation, but by God's system of seed time and harvest. Galatians 6:7-9. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that also will he reap. I believe that I have sowed into good ground, and I believe that when I sow seed into good ground, I reap an immediate 100-fold return in the name of Jesus. Habakkuk 2:23, Write the vision and make it plain on a tablet, that he may run who reads it, for the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it will speak and it will not lie. Though it tarries, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Psalms 35:27, Let them shout for joy and be glad who favor my righteous cause. Let them say continually, The Lord, let the Lord be magnified, who has pleasure in the prosperity of his servants. Therefore, as his servant, I declare I am out of debt. All my needs are met. I have plenty more to put in store. I have a heart. I have a hearing heart, because I meditate on God's word daily. As a result, I hear God's word. I hear his voice clearly, and I operate in his wisdom and anointing. Isaiah 30:21, Your ears shall hear a word behind you saying, This is the way, walk in it. Whenever you turn to the right or left. Proverbs 4:23, Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it flows the issues of life. Therefore, I refuse to allow anything to come before my eyes, in my ears, or out of my mouth that does not line up with the word of God. I purpose to guard my heart diligently by bringing every thought, action, or desire into submission to the Word of God. Casting down, as it says in 2 Corinthians 10:5, casting down every argument and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. Proverbs 36:11, if they obey and serve Him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasures. But if they do not obey, they shall perish by the sword, and they shall die without knowledge. Psalms 25:12-14, who is the man that fears the Lord? Him shall He teach in the way he chooses. He himself shall dwell in prosperity, and his descendants shall inherit the earth. The secret of the Lord is with those who fear Him, and He will show them His salvation. Deuteronomy 28:1-14, if you obey the Lord your God and faithfully keep all His commands that I am giving you today, He will make you greater than any other nation on earth. Obey the Lord your God, and all these blessings will be yours. The Lord will bless your towns and your fields. The Lord will bless you with many children, with abundant crops, with many cattle and sheep. The Lord will bless your grain and the food you prepare for them. The Lord will bless everything you do. The Lord will defeat your enemies when they attack you. They will attack you from one direction, but run from you in all directions. The Lord your God will bless your work and fill your barns with grain. He will bless you in the land that He has given you. The Lord your God will make you the leader among nations and not a follower. You will always prosper and never fail if you obey faithfully all His commandments that I am giving you this day. But you must never disobey them in any way, or worship or serve any other gods. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Thank you, Jesus, for this time, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for allowing me to bask in your presence. But even though I know this time is over right now, that you are with me 24/7, Lord, I thank you for that, Lord. I praise your name continuously, and I give you praise. Hallelujah. Lord, bless the reading of His word, and may the Lord bless us this day in giving quality time to the Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.